I would say never, because even when I sleep, sometimes I dream about these experiences and they're really uncomfortable. Mostly they are nightmares.
As a white male, I very rarely experience any type of discrimination. As a man, I very rarely experience discrimination on the basis of my gender.
Never ever.
Where do we start?
Yeah.
Name calling? Whistling after you?
Well, sexism happens everywhere. It happens in schools, at the workplace, in public space, in restaurants,
bars,
and the street.
Because we don't experience it anywhere else, this is our only chance to do it.
Because you also sometimes you experience domination, which is subconscious, you know, from the part of some men. They don't feel like they're being aggressive or dominating in a discussion, but you know, you kind of feel it. You pull back a little bit.
I mean, they don't want to be, but you know, we're taught to, like, we are, how we have to, how we should behave and what to say and how to act. So it's like on an unconscious level, but still we women feel uncomfortable because of it.
Women's safety spaces are so necessary because some of the patterns, I will say, even myself, I reproduce them very often, and I catch myself reproducing them very often, even if I really consciously try to avoid them. But you know, it's something that I grew up with, that I was told pretty much my whole life until now, that it's still being told to me by media, by politics, by all of the areas that we experience in public and in private life.
To be honest, I think society is a men's space, so I don't really see why you need to create a men's space inside a men's space. That makes no sense to me whatsoever. For me, men's spaces are happening anyhow, all the time, in bars while the women are taking care of the children. Or going for a beer, like all this networking stuff is so male that male space is everywhere, so it doesn't need any more attention.
I will put in an analogy as well with heterosexuals, when they always say to me, why do you always need these gay spaces? Why do you have to go to a gay club? Why do you have to make a pride? And so on and so on. And then I will really say, well, you have the whole world for you.
I would accept men's spaces where men critically reflect about the masculinity and think why there's a oppressed group and why there's oppression. This would be a good idea, but I wouldn't call it a men's free space or so, because it's a different role in society.
For me, what's important to remember is that individual men can face discrimination for whatever reason, because they don't conform to society's idea of a construction of masculinity, because whatever. But men as a whole aren't an oppressed class in the same way that women are.
Well, discrimination of men can maybe in some isolated cases exist, but it's not structural. The discrimination of women is just everywhere.
I don't know, I just had like the best party ever. In a women's safe space, and it was like really great, and it's just like you can talk about everything without having a fear that you have to explain or complain for something that you say.
I feel very comfortable, and I feel more relaxed. I feel that what I'm doing is important, and that that what I do is important, that I am important as a person, and that what I say, what I do has some values more than in some other places.
It's quite nice to just come together to think about what happens in the daily life, also to reflect a bit about feminist theories, to think about feminist history. It's quite important, and it gives a lot of power and a lot of power to go on with the struggle.
It gives you a kind of strength. Sometimes it's only because you feel nice and you feel more comfortable, but sometimes it's because you speak with people who have the same experience and you kind of think about how can we change society. So it's always about the empowerment in different ways.
Initially, when I first encountered it, I felt excluded and I had mixed feelings about it, because I didn't necessarily understand, having been a man my whole life, has never been something we discussed in our organizations, and always had an image of, oh, we're all equal and sort of stuff, so there's no need to divide people and create secluded spaces and exclude anybody. As it has been explained to me, and as I have talked to people, that to women that have been in those spaces and what they get out of it, it made me understand the need, where it's not about them wanting to exclude me as an individual, but the fact that me, because of my gender and not being able to, not being a woman, would just ruin the dynamics and the safe space and the ability for people to feel relaxed enough to share. It doesn't necessarily make me feel not excluded, but I respect the need for it, and I want them to have that space to benefit from it. And my personal feelings don't necessarily count into that, because I will see them after they walk out of that space, but what happens within that space cannot be reproduced anywhere else. And this is why I strongly believe that safe spaces and women's evenings and things like that need to happen.